Hey everyone, continuing with our Adobe Aero project, creating a little mushroom forest, we've moved on to Adobe Dimension using the previously exported assets. If you're not familiar with Dimension, it's a 3D rendering and design program, part of the Creative Cloud. You'll see a similar workspace to Adobe Aero, same set of tools. You have starter assets, plus models, materials, and lighting. We even have our same Aero navigation tools, such as the pan, dolly, orbit, but now a sampler and magic wand. There's the zoom tool and the select tool with a little bit of extras. Let's go ahead and start importing our assets separately by clicking the import icon, which is similar to Aero. Import your content, then the 3D model. Okay, the heart file is next. We'll organize assets on the scene. Double check the name of the layer and label. Now the mushroom. You can label the different parts. Here we have the base and the top. Let's clean up these spots and add back using basic sphere shapes and dimension. Some things are just better to deal with here than in Illustrator. Back to importing. Moving these over here because I want to add some extra detail to these items later. We have the pawn. Rotate 90 degrees while holding the shift button. Got some rocks. Thinking it would be cool to add material to these to give it some texture, but also want to keep in mind that I want the experience 50 megabytes or smaller. So for now, I'm a limited amount of materials I use on the assets, and if I have more room later, I can go back and add them. A tree. Don't worry about the size at the moment. A thing to note, even though they were grouped when exporting in Illustrator, you can edit each part individually in Dimension. Group objects just create a folder once you import into Dimension. Just click on the folder icon to open and select the part you want to edit. For example, you can adjust the leaves here and maybe add some materials or adjust the size. And make sure you select the folder when moving the object. Let's name this one Rock 1, and so on. Name this pawn. The group objects seem to be the one that import with names, so always double check so you always know what you're moving around and adding animations to. A few more imports to go. A tree. All right, let's update a few assets. Select the pawn, go to select base model, click on a color to add your previously used colors, because when you add a material, it will change your base color, and I just really like this blue. You'll notice the pond did not keep the water material from the Illustrator file, so go to materials in the starter assets, select the water material, and don't forget to add a blue back. Moving on to the mushroom, let's grab a spear. In the scene layers, click the arrow on the layer to adjust, make it white. Make it less shiny, a little rough to make it look natural. You can adjust metallic, glow, and opacity on the translucence. And realizing I forgot to import the water orb or bubble, so let's add that back to the scene real quick. Now I want the bubble to be in the same color as the pond and give it the same material treatment, and back to the mushroom. Let's take this spear and make extruding spots and duplicate across both mushroom tops. All right, now that the details are added, we can start exporting. Again, if you'd like to keep exploring, feel free to play around with the objects and add materials here. Personally, I'm gonna leave as is to keep file size minimal at the moment. So to export, we will select an asset or the folder, choose file, export, then choose select it for Aero, and export one at a time to your computer. Don't forget to add file names and repeat. So sometimes you may get this message. Usually this means it'll be a bigger file, often happens with complex assets. But most of the time you're able to still keep the experience under 50 megabytes, so I usually export anyway. And if you prefer to try, you can remove the materials here and just keep it a normal bubble. And we're done exporting these 3D assets from Adobe Dimension for Aero. Hope this is a great intro into Dimension for some, if not all. And now in the next lesson, we'll import these assets to Aero and create our last experience with the course.